Hey guys, I'm Zach Penn. I'm one of the Penn Twins from Penn Twins Vlogs, and today we're going to be comparing a $800 drone versus a $60 drone. Start off this vlog, I want guys to let you know that if you could, please like, comment, subscribe, and tell me what you think of this video. Do you think spending more money is going to be worth this drone, or do you think maybe a $60 drone is up your market and you might want to go for this? Now, to start it off, I want to let you guys know this is the Maverick Air. It goes for $799 on the DJI website, and then this you can buy at like a Myers or a Target or a Walmart, and this is $59.99, and this is called the DX5. So we want to compare these. Let's compare the battery life for both these. This battery life can go for 21 minutes for the Maverick Air, where for the DX5, I tested it and it could last around 30 minutes. So obviously this has stronger lifetime for batteries. So let's say you're filming for airsoft. That's a hobby that my friends and I do. You don't have to worry about the time as much with this because it's 30 minutes. And what's going to last more than 30 minutes? Not often. 21 minutes, you should be good too, but you never know. So this has the slight edge on time. Now the difference between both these with the time is this actually has a battery that you can put in. So you can buy multiple batteries. So the moment this dies, you can just switch it out, put another one in. This, on the other hand, you have to charge it. There's a UPS port right here, UPS port right there. And every time it dies, you have to charge it. And it usually takes an hour to fully charge. So that can be a downside. So you have the Maverick Air right off the bat. If you have more than one battery, you have a higher chance of, oh, just slip another one in. Well, you're gonna have to charge this one, the DX5. If you're looking at just a 30 minute one time flight period, obviously this would be the option if you're just looking at flight time. But this one has chances where you can switch out a battery, switch another one in. So if you need to film longer, as long as you're willing to spend a little more money for more batteries, you'll be set. Now, something else I want to talk about is the next step, controls. What is easier on for the controls? Now, I'm going to be showing you footage while I'm talking. Hopefully, we'll have a voiceover. We're going to start off with the Maverick Air. So if you're looking at the Maverick Air, the controls are pretty easy. They're pretty fluid. Nick usually runs the Maverick Air because it's his, so he likes to fly around with it. But overall, the controls are easy to use. You can fly, control it a lot smoothly, and overall the controls are nice. You can go up and down pretty easily. You can have different modes. That's a really cool thing you can do. You can have tracking mode or quick mode. I think it's called quick mode. You know, you can go super quick or whatever. There's a bunch of different modes you can do, as well as it's very smooth when you're turning. Now, if you look at the DX5, you're gonna see that it's moving very quickly. It's hard to control. If you look at the actual controller, the DX5, it looks nice, but when you're using it, it moves so quickly, it's hard to control. It's hard to figure out which direction you're going in, how you're spinning. And overall, I say the controls for this, you need to either be someone who likes speed racing for drones, or you need to be very, very good at this control. For me, I've never flown a drone before. I mean, I messed around with Nick's DJI Maverick Air drone before, but I've never messed with any other drone. So this drone, it's cheaper. You can tell the controls are cheaper, and it's a lot harder to control. It's not as smooth and not as easy. And so you have to be more of an expert how to fly drones, I feel like, with this $60 one. You can't just never fly a drone before and then boom, plug this one in. Now we want to say video quality. Right off the bat, you know the DJI Maverick Air is gonna have the better video quality. It's at 4K. You can get up to 4K, where the DX5 only does 1080p. So if you care about that much quality, you already know the Maverick Air is going to have better quality. But it's just not my word against it. We're gonna show you footage side by side comparing both of the footage. As you can see, the Maverick Air is a lot more smoother and cleaner looking, where the DX5 isn't. There's more pixels, it doesn't look as clear, and that's because of the different quality it's made. As well as in the Maverick Air, there was stabilization in this, and you can see how stable it is and how smooth it is, where the DX5, because it's hard to control, it makes it so you can't have the stabilization. As well as if you look inside this, there's no stabilization built inside this drone. This is all it is. It's a little light right there. You can see the red, and there's no stabilization in it. So unless you're being super stable with the DX5, it's not not going to be a stable shot. And for a lot of drone footage, you're going to want stable shot. It looks smoother. You don't want it shaking around. And already, it's already going to be harder to watch. So when it comes down to it, the Mavic Air is the superior when it comes to video quality, comes to filming, and comes to stabilization. Is the DX5 worth the value? And if you're going to be filming, is it worth airsoft? Now, you've seen the footage comparing both. You've seen the pros and cons of both of them, and this is a very light, I'm not going super in depth with both of these. I'm going on a very broad generalization. I'm going on a very broad area on both these drones. And if you want to have a very, very good quality drone, extremely good quality drone, you want great footage, you want stabilization, you have to be willing to spend more money. So overall, I give the Mavic Air all the positives, and that's because, you know, you pay for what you get. Anyways, this is Zach Penn, one of the Penns from Penn Twins Vlogs. Please like, comment, and subscribe. It means the world to us. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. I hope you guys learned something. And remember, if you're going to get into filming, especially with drones, be willing to spend a little more money to get the better quality.